This is Garrett with Syngenta again with some real quick root samples to kind of demonstrate what we look for with Phytophthora, and also why we think that not only looking at the big roots, but also looking at the small fine feeder roots is really important. So first of all, when we get calls to come out and sample Phytophthora, we look at all the root system, multiple trees, multiple areas to try and get an evaluation of what's going on. If you look at this, most often people will look at these big roots, and you look at this, this looks like a nice healthy root. It's nice and white. It's got a lot of structure to it. It doesn't pull apart very easily. It's got a lot of good qualities to it. I've seen many times where people will come out from different agencies. They'll either just look at these big roots like this. They'll look at the crown of the tree and think, hey, everything's fine. It's not Phytophthora. I kind of feel like we're stopping before we're getting to the full root of what might be going on. Root. And because we forget about these roots, right? These are the smaller ones. These are the ones that are small. You look at this big one. This doesn't look too bad either, if you can see that. But what you're missing is all of these fine little feeder roots. If you can see there, I'll get it kind of close to the camera. They're dark in color. They don't have really any structure to them. They kind of fall apart, break apart very, very easily. You can see it just comes right off. It's got this reddish brown color to it. And so these roots are being overlooked completely when we go to fields and we don't look at them. And just because Phytophthora hasn't infected these yet doesn't mean that these have no consequence. And you look at this here, this system, especially in double line drip or sprinkler systems, these root systems of trees now have adapted. They become much more fibrous, closer to the surface, you know, the top foot of soil, very, very concentrated, which means it's very perfect for Phytophthora to happen. These smaller roots are actually very susceptible to Phytophthora infection. It doesn't take long for them to be completely eaten up. And if you look at this, this bit of soil here, there's small roots all through this, tons of them that get bypassed when we don't look at those. Okay, so what I like to use is analogies a lot to kind of describe what we're seeing here. And so if I could describe a root system as an analogy, it would be like a mass transit system. And so when you look at these fine feeder roots here, these are kind of like the surface streets in the suburbs, right? They transmit water and nutrients, we'll say in this terms it's people, to bigger roots like this, and then to bigger roots like this. So the water and nutrients feed from these smaller ones into here. They go into the trunk system, and then they go up into the leaf canopy, and that's where they're going to work, basically. So if you imagine that system of travel as you go on your commute daily to the office, let's just say these surface streets were gone, right? How do you get to work? You don't. And so that's the same thing with water and nutrients. If these small roots here, all of these small, you see them all through here, if all these small fine feeder roots are eaten up and they aren't very efficient, it doesn't matter how healthy these roots are, the tree is gonna suffer because it can't gather the amount of water and nutrients it needs to sustain itself.